If you're thinking about doing the same fuse box relocation that I just did to the trunk of your car, please don't. It is not worth it. What is up, guys? Today I'll be doing something a little bit different than usual. I did not think that I'd be showing this, but seeing all the interest on Instagram and all the questions, I figured it could be really helpful to you guys. So it's all about wiring today, and if you know the STI, you'll recognize this wiring harness. This is the part that goes right between your engine harness and the interior harness, so it houses all of the fuse and the fuse box, basically. So what's going on here, a little bit of a background story. I put those tubs in, and that's where the fuse box usually sits, so right about here. Now I don't have room anymore, so what some people do is they put the fuse box underneath the fender, which I'm not going to do. So now I'm running into this issue where I don't know where to put the fuse box, and the only place I can think of is the trunk. So I know this looks a little bit confusing right now, but bear with me one second and I'll go through it real quick. You guys should understand it in no time. If you imagine this part of the harness being connected to the inside of the car, this is where the wires start. Everything else runs off of there to the outside of the car and to the different sensors and all that. So we have the fuse box in the middle, which I'm trying to take and place to the back of the car. So what I need to do is basically disconnect all of the wires around the fuse box so that I can take it, place it in the back without modifying any of the other wires and sensors and all that. In short, I want to be able to take the box and have it be completely independent of all the other parts of the wiring harness so that I can just kind of take it and then pull it back through the car and place it in the trunk. Alright, now that's looking pretty good. I've got the same connectors as before going to the inside of the car in this section here. And then you can see this entire back section is new. That's all separated, going to the trunk with the fuse box and all that. So that's exactly what I wanted. And the rest of the harness is all up here going to the front of the car. Alright, so now I can throw everything back in the car and see how much length I need to add. So the current state is a complete mess. I've cut all of the wires going to the fuse box right about there under the dash so that I can extend them, because obviously if I place the fuse box in the back, the wires aren't long enough to reach over there. So that's what I did here. I cut literally everything off, and now I need to extend each of those wires from here all the way to the dash. And that's where I'll put a connector or a couple of connectors so I can actually disconnect this back section of the harness with the fuse box and have the front going separate to the engine bay. So that's the game plan, and I've actually changed my mind. I was gonna put the battery on the left side because that's easier, it's shorter routing, and it's quite convenient here. There's more room on this side as well in this trunk. But I'm gonna put it on the right side to offset the weight of the drivers. So that's something you typically do on a race car to get the center of gravity as close as possible to the center of the car. So on the left side, you've got the driver, you've got the steering column and a bunch of other stuff, which adds weight. So you want to offset that with the battery, which is what I'm doing here. And I'll have the fuse box right behind it somewhere like this. So that's the new location of the fuse box. Now you saw all the wires going to the front there that needs to be extended. I did four of them already here, and those land right about here. So I'm connecting them to the underside down there. You can't see, but I've got all my cut wires over there. And I was actually able to salvage a bunch of those wires from an old wiring harness. So I've got a lot of wires and a good connector here that I'm gonna use. So that's gonna be for all the small wires. Now, there are quite a few of those bigger wires, and I'm not sure exactly how I'll connect them, but I think tomorrow I'll be able to pick up a new connector from the stores, and that should be all good to go afterwards. And on this side, you can see the rest of the loom. That's just everything as it was from factory, except those are my salvage wires. So yeah, I've got a few wires here that need to be extended all the way from the front of the car to the fuse box, but most of the wires only need to run to these connectors down here. So that's a shorter distance. Now those are obviously longer. So I had to get a bunch of new wires, which you can see right there. Bunch of different sizes too. I went all the way up to 4 gauge. I actually did get some 0 gauge or odd gauge, but those are way too big to run in here and way too heavy. Since I'm putting both the battery and the fuse box in the trunk, I don't need such big wires to run inside the car and to bring the power from the battery to the front of the car, because most of the power will be going to the fuse box and then get split throughout all those little wires. So if you're just putting the battery in the trunk, you need big wires to bring all the power that you can to the front of the car. But in my case, the only big wires that I need go from the battery to the starter motor, and that's fine being 4 gauge, so that's this size right here, compared to the 0 gauge. You can see it hopefully right there. So it's quite a big difference, but this is what is run from factory. So I'm gonna keep the same size. There's no need to go extra with that size and weight. That's just added weight for nothing. So I'll go with this and I should be fine. Also, I'll change the routing a little bit, because from the factory, your wires go from the starter motor down here to the battery, which sits right here. Since that's gone, I can run them directly from the starter through the firewall and then down into the car. So I'll be going that way, and that's a lot shorter.
Obviously, I'll be showing the final result in a minute, but for now, I really need to get to work. It is now Thursday night, and I promised myself that the engine would be running by Saturday afternoon. So that leaves me tonight, tomorrow night, and some of Saturday to finish all of this crazy work and get everything working properly. I should probably get back to work right now. So I don't think I'm gonna make it. Today is already Saturday, and this is only how far I've gotten. I've extended the entire loom all the way from the fuse box down there to the front bulkhead. So that's all good to go, but I still have to put all of the connectors on the end of this, make everything match, and then gotta replicate the exact same connections on the other side. So you can see here, there's a bunch of wires that are just loose. So those need connectors as well, and then some wires in the front need extended all the way to here and put into the connectors as well. So that's a lot of work still. Most of it is done, because that was definitely a lot of work down there. But yeah, now I'm gonna attack the connectors and then see what I can do about the rest of those wires. All right, so the back half of the wiring harness is officially done. Everything has been extended from the fuse box all the way to the connectors up here. And I just spent about an hour labeling every single wire on this thing to make sure that I connect it to the right wire inside the car. Now in the stores, I could only find red and black cables. So half of the cables here are black and red. The other half I could salvage off of another wiring harness. So you can see those look
factory, and they are, just not from this car. So all of those colors do not match either, and I had to trace every cable down the wiring harness and back to the fuse box to label it the correct color. So that's what all those little pieces of tape mean. And now I can actually bundle everything up and throw it in the car, and I should have everything ready on this side to connect to the rest of the car. For those wondering what kind of connectors I'm using, I tried to reuse as many of the factory connectors as I could. So all these connectors are from the standard Subaru harness. And then these two, still missing the connector here, but those will be the same. And they're from an audio system for cars specifically. And they're exactly the same size as this factory connector here. So it should perform just fine. And the special one is this guy. That's an Anderson type connector, and it's specifically made for power output. You can see there is a plus and a minus here. In my case, I'm just using it, I believe, for the power coming from the alternator, going to the fuse box, and then recharging the battery. So I wanted those separate to make sure there's no interference, and they're actually pretty beefy cables. I think those are 8 gauge. But these connectors can go up to, I think, 4 gauge, and there's a bigger one for all the way up to 8 gauge. So if you're looking for power connectors, definitely check Anderson connectors out. So that's what I'm using, and as long as I connect everything correctly, it should work just fine. All right, I'm finally done with the whole wiring mess. It is currently installed, so everything is plugged in over there, but I still need to go ahead and bundle everything up, make it look like an actual loom rather than just a few cables running around the car. But for now, I want to keep it this way so I can access it easily and make sure everything is working properly before going ahead and making it look nice. Now, in the rear, I do have a lot of extra length, so all of this isn't really necessary, but I didn't know where I was gonna put the fuse box. So initially I thought over there, right behind the battery. That's why I had all this length. Now I'm thinking I could actually put it over there and remove a bunch of those wires. But I'm also thinking I could somehow attach it to the top here, make it run across and then down, possibly place the fuse box over here on top of the battery or somewhere, and it would be really tidy. Not sure yet, so for now I'm just gonna leave it this way and think about it a little bit. Now coming to the front, you can see the wires running down here along the side of the car and all the way to the front there. And all of my connectors here, those are new connectors that I added, and it seems to work just fine. The rest is all factory stuff, so the fuse box hasn't moved. And if we go to the front, you can see the front of the harness here, which still hasn't changed, but it's open and I still need to route it correctly and bundle everything up again.
Now, speaking of which, there is still one part of the wiring that hasn't been addressed, and that's the battery. All of the cables running from the battery to the starter motor need to be extended as well. There's always a good news and a bad news, and the bad news is it's a little bit more complicated than just extending the cables like we did with the rest of the loom, because we need to add a circuit breaker and some terminal posts to disconnect everything in the front. But the good news is I do have everything in stock, so I can go ahead and do it right now. Let me show you what we have and what the plan is, and then we'll get it done. So there we have a bunch of positive and negative power wires. Those are 4 gauge. I did not feel the need to go higher in gauge because this is the standard size that Subaru uses, so it should be fine. Next, I'm going to use this 200 amp circuit breaker. It acts like a fuse in my case, but it lets me reset the system without changing any components. So that's neat. Also got a bunch of 4 gauge welded terminals, so nothing crazy there. And finally, a positive and negative isolated terminal post. This I'm going to use to be able to disconnect the rear section of those cables to the front in case I want to just remove the engine with the starter and the cables. A pretty cool thing is that they come with the isolation boots, so that's really practical, and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna use those.
So the way that I want to set everything up is like this. I'll have the battery right here, the cutoff switch right above for easy access, and then a positive terminal right behind it. This allows me to split the power between the starter motor in the front and then the fuse box next to the battery. Now, the reason why the terminal post is behind the cutoff switch is that I want the cutoff switch to act like a fuse and disconnect all of the power inside the car if there is a short. So the first thing that the positive terminal will go to is the cutoff switch, and then it will split to the different components of the car. So I guess the first thing to do now is going to be connecting the positive terminal of the battery to the cutoff switch, and then that to the terminal post behind. And now I can go ahead and connect the positive from the fuse box directly to that terminal, like so. I know there is a fuse in here for that positive lead, so the fuse box and everything is protected already, but I wanted to set the system up this way so I can actually disconnect everything in case I want to store the car. But this step is not necessary. I could just go ahead and connect this straight from the terminal here. I just want to set it up this way, that's personal. So yeah, it just gives me that extra peace of mind and the ability to disconnect everything from here whenever I want to. So I guess now the final step for the positive side of the circuit is to connect the terminal all the way up to the starter motor. I've just finished the negative side of the system as well. So this is what connects to my battery. It's got two leads coming off of it. So one is a direct ground to the strut tower right there. I'm not going to keep it this way, but it was convenient, I guess, for now. The other lead goes straight to the front of the car and to the starter motor. Finally, in the engine bay, you can see both cables running to here, and those connect straight to my starter motor. So I've got the right connections already set up. Now, before I can go ahead and install this thing somewhere down there, I need to go ahead and install the steering column, the dash, and everything else in this area, because this is one of the last things that you want to install. Otherwise, everything else gets in the way and it's a pain. So for now, we are officially done with the wiring. Now, at this point, I just want to say something and give you guys a piece of advice. If you're thinking about doing the same fuse box relocation that I just did to the trunk of your car, please don't. It is not worth it. You'll spend way too much time for something that actually doesn't make a difference. The system, the electrical system, has not changed. It is exactly how it was before. It's just relocated. And unless you're really sure that you can't fit it anywhere in your engine bay, don't do it. Man, it's not worth it. It adds a lot of weight in wiring. I haven't weighed it, but I know I've added quite a few kilograms of just wires, which doesn't make sense. And honestly, I probably should have relocated it to the fender. But once I was this far into it, I couldn't back up anymore. And I guess I just had to finish it. But I guess for now, it is what it is. I just wanted to tell you guys that it's not an enjoyable process and it just doesn't add any value. That being said, I am super excited because the car is really close to being able to start again. It has been over a year now since the engine has run. The last time it did run was during that first test drive video where we actually did the STI swap and got the car out for a spin. That was the last time that the engine officially ran. After that, we started tearing into the body and the roll cage and everything. So the car hasn't run since then, but I have a feeling that today might be the day. So what do we need to do to make the car start again? That's pretty obvious. I need a steering column, a steering wheel. I need the pedals attached to some master cylinders in back. And I need the dashboard installed. What else do we need? We need a seat. We need a radiator, maybe, if I have time. And we need to plug all of this wiring back in. Also, we need an intake and an intercooler as well. So quite a few things, but it should just be bolt-ons. So I guess I want to start with the steering column, the dashboard, make sure everything still fits with the new wiring. And yeah, then I can put the starter motor and we'll see what comes next. All right, so I just got my steering column and gas pedal installed. I messed up the footage, that's why you didn't see it. But I realized before I go any further, I need to take care of my fuel lines because right now they interfere with the roll cage and they're not routing correctly. Puts a lot of tension in them and it's not going to be efficient that way. So I want to cut them off completely and replace them with soft lines. This is high pressure fuel line, so it should be plenty strong. I think it holds up to like 225 PSI or something. So it should be plenty with the stock engine. I'm actually just replacing the section from the firewall down to here where it drops down to the fuel tank because I just want to get it around the roll cage, but I'm not trying to make it flow better or anything like that. I actually need to keep the hard lines in the front to make it look factory so that it passes the Swiss laws, so it would be street legal, but it will be soft in the middle. And in the end, once I actually drop the big boy engine, I'll have to redesign the fuel system anyways, so there will be a surge tank, there will be full AN lines, but for now, this is just a quick fix, and it should be all right. All right, so I've got my fuel lines cut and cleaned up. Now I'm going to use this flanging kit to create a little lip at the end of the tube, so I can actually push the soft hose onto it and it has something to grab onto and it won't just slip off and create a mess inside the car. Now, I've never used one of those, so it'll be interesting, but it shouldn't be that hard. But I won't be using it to create what it's supposed to do, like the proper connections like you would do on brake lines and stuff. I just want to do a little lip like there is on this side here, so the hose doesn't fly off. So it should work just fine. Let's try it. And there it is, I'm done flaring the tubes. It didn't come out super clean, but it should work just fine. So let's go ahead and put them back in the car and then I can measure the correct length of soft lines and actually install them. If I could, and I would, count your heart. So I've actually just realized that I'm missing the proper fuel hose clamps to go with this, so I could actually connect my lines, but it wouldn't be secure, so there is no point in testing the car today. So I think that's what I'm going to leave to this video with just the fuse box relocation and battery relocation. I think that's plenty. And I'm super excited to start the car again, finally. Unfortunately for you guys, it's going to have to be in the next video, so if you don't want to miss it, make sure to hit the subscribe button, and if you want real-time progress of the build, head over to Instagram at SwissTuned. You'll find me there posting every week about the latest updates on the build. Now, I really hope that you liked seeing the fuse box relocation. It's been a lot of work and a lot of people are afraid of wiring. It's really not that hard. It takes a lot of time. It's a lot of work, but it's not that difficult. Now, again, I would not recommend it unless you really, really have to, like in my case, and it's even debatable. At least you know what it takes now, and I'd say it's about 50 hours of work plus minus. So definitely not something you can do over the weekend or that you can wing. So keep that in mind and take your decisions accordingly. Now I'm gonna quit rambling, but thank you guys so much for watching, all of the support and everything. It's awesome. I really enjoy it. It does make the build that much more interesting and motivating to me. So thanks a lot again, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.